It's a lot quieter around here since all the kids moved out. Make yourself comfortable, Ian. Would you like some coffee or tea?
Tea sounds great, thanks. Coffee gives me the jitters. You've got a nice place here, Dan. It feels really homey.
Thanks, Ian. So, continuing our conversation about the Antediluvian period, we're at Genesis chapter 7. Are you ready to continue? And God spoke to Noah.
Go into the ark, you and all your household, for I have seen that you are righteous before me in this generation. Take with you 7 pairs of all clean animals, the male and his mate, and a pair of the animals that are not clean, the male and his mate, and 7 pairs of the birds of the heavens also, male and female, to keep their offspring alive on the face of all the earth. For in 7 days I will send rain on the earth 40 days and 40 nights, and every living thing that I've made I will blot out from the face of the ground.
And Noah did all that Jehovah had commanded him. He did not have to search for the animals, but the animals all came to him.
How did the animals on other continents travel across the ocean to board the ark?
Great question. You see, back then, the continents were all together in a supercontinent called Pangaea. So, there was no ocean to cross. The animals could simply walk to the ark.
Interesting. But what about the flood itself? How did it happen?
The Bible describes it as a cataclysmic event. It came suddenly on a normal day. After Noah and his family and all the animals entered the ark, Jehovah shut the door.
Wait a second. About 5 years have passed, right? If one of the giants were killed, as I've seen in that earlier vision, wouldn't the other Nephilim have gotten really angry and waged war against Noah?
The vision you saw might not have unfolded exactly like that, for the Bible doesn't specify the cause of Lamech's death. Some ancient texts suggest he died before reaching 900 years due to a lack of faith. But that's a faulty assumption. Even the Messiah, who was perfect, died in his 30s. The vision could be more symbolic. I noticed the beast the giant rode had 10 horns, which is significant. In biblical symbolism, horns often represent power and authority. And the number 10 can symbolize completeness or a multitude of kings. We'll see a similar beast in the book of Daniel. Regardless, even if all the armies of the world came against Noah, it wouldn't have mattered.
What do you mean?
Lord, show him.
Today we will take vengeance on Noah for slaying our brother. And those sons of Seth will curse the day they cross the mighty Anunnaki. To war!
Anunnaki?
That's what they called themselves, which means princely offspring, as opposed to the derogatory Nephilim, which means fallen ones.
What in the world is that?
A battle cruiser.
What's going on? Things are blowing up without any shots fired.
Pay close attention, Ian. Through the smoke.
Whoa. I see now. They are armed with laser weapons.
Not that. There is something else.
What?
Destroyed them all in one swift stroke.